friends. Welcome to our home for another video. If you're new here, my name is Brittany Doolittle, and today we are making over our powder room. This was a lot of work, but I love the way it turned out. I hope this gives you some inspiration if you have a project that you've been meaning to tackle, or if you just like watching friend transformations and watching this unfold. Either way, I'm really glad you're here. Now let's begin.
Yesterday, there was sun and there was rain.
I could say hi.
Is that Brit?
Sorry. Hi. Hi. Okay, so we're gonna start feeling a boost of motivation. My husband said it's all sanded down, it's ready to go, except of course there's probably a couple spots he forgot to take. It's so bright you can't see the anchor out right here from the old towel rod thing. But you know what? Probably gonna have to sand anyway. I just want to get the boards up. I just want to get the primary. So I don't think I've said it. It might be obvious. We're going to do board and batten in here. Like a tall board and batten. So I just want to get those up. We don't have a brad nailer. We just weren't ready to make that financial move. Buying that, they're at least the ones we looked at were kind of expensive, so anyway, we have to nail them by hand, and so I'm really apprehensive about it. I almost want to wait until my husband gets home, but he's also working, and so I can't get like depend on him being able to jump in and help me at my whim. So I'm gonna try it. I think maybe I wonder if I should start on the back wall, do the longest board. So let's just do it. Let's just see how that goes. So let's do this back wall. I gotta measure it. But yeah, so we're gonna do board and batten, and the bottom, the board and batten and down will be this green. That's the same green as our bedroom. And then I wanted the darker, but my husband likes the more pure white. It's not pure white, it's ethereal white. But he likes that better, so we're gonna go with this on top. So all the rest of the way. We are also going to be changing out the light. We have this, what is it called? Like a Hollywood light. And I got a new one on sale at Wayfair. So that's exciting. We have a new toilet paper holder. And then not a like a new towel holder, but before it was the ring. And I just, I don't know why I really don't like them. I just don't like them. And we have these, let me see if I, we had these hooks everywhere throughout the house. Everywhere. I mean, there's one on the back of the door, I'm sure. I see. Yep. They just left them on the back of every door. And although it's not like beautiful and like, you know, it's better to me functionally than the round towel holder. And so we're just going to put this up. It was free. I didn't have to buy it. And it matches all the other hardware. So, all right, friends, I'm going to turn to action mode now. So let's go.
I was so excited to get this first board up. I don't know. I just needed that reassurance that I could do this. I think I love having help. I love that me and my husband get to do these projects and it them be our projects. I'm going to be honest. I think I like having help secondarily to having mutual projects is having mutual responsibility. So if something goes wrong, it's not just my fault. I was really excited to get that done. I did it on my own. I feel like I'm a very capable woman, but I like sharing in that responsibility. So this felt good. So I'm just using MDF. We got these from Lowe's and we're using just small nails. Like I said before, we just weren't ready to commit to a brad nailer. At least the ones that we saw at our hardware store were just pricey. And we even have other projects in the future that we would want to use one for, but it just wasn't something we were ready to do. So we thought we could do it good old fashioned, hammering it in. And then you'll see later we take I don't know what they're called, but it's a little tool to sink the nails in further. We needed it for something else. So it just worked. You see I'm using it here. So anyway, we have our, I don't know, is this the batten? Is this the board part of it? That's done. So now we're going to measure for the battens, for the vertical boards. And we decided, since this is the first wall that you see when you walk in, that we're going to focus on this wall, let this be the precedent for the measurements for the rest of the walls. So we just centered this first board and then I take the difference in the empty space on either side and then I center the other two boards in that. And that gave me the measurement in between all the other boards. So right here you see me going ahead on the wall behind the door. We had to decide, I originally wanted to space them out differently, but my husband convinced me to just go ahead and do the same process where we center the first board and then measure outward, even if, anyway, it's a lot to explain whenever I'm going this fast on the video. So anyway, we got our measurements that way. So we're going to go ahead and get these boards up there with these nails. Some of the boards just didn't sit flush. So we did put some caulking behind it, but we'll get there. Get a little peek at my cute little boy modeling mommy and hammering with his little toy hammer. So anyway, let's keep going. So we are finally to caulking, and such a big difference. I know every video that does these kinds of makeovers, they mention how important caulking is, but it definitely is, gives it that finished and built-in type of look. So I'm just doing a very thin, you don't want to cut the tip of the caulk gun too wide, or you're going to get a lot of excess. And what I like to do is release the pressure once I'm going to start smoothing it out, so it's not billowing out at the top. But you want a damp cloth to wipe the excess either off your hand or off the wall. And then when I do have excess, either from the line that I just made or from the tip, I like to go into the more difficult areas. So you see the corners, and that's what you see me doing here. So also, we did use the caulking in the nail holes. I don't know if we just didn't do it very well, but I wasn't convinced this would do well. My husband was, but we still see the nail holes even through the paint. So I would probably next time just use like a wood filler. Maybe that would give a better coverage on the nail holes, but that could also just be an us problem, user error. But we are going to be cleaning up because I am determined on this day to paint. This was Thursday. We had been at this for several days, and I did not expect it to take this long, and I was determined. So we're painting today, but I need to get it cleaned up first, and then the fun part.
You said, let me tell you everything I've seen, the friends I've made, and then you tell me how you've been. Look a little closer, it's been quite some time, but you gotta let me know if I'm out of line. But there's some words that I just wanna say, to put it all straight before this night turns into day. Me on my knees. Now's the time to reap what I've sown. Your words echoing in every single bone. Underwater, so far out at sea. There's no cure for what you're telling me. And soon I'm on my way. Thank you.
case you haven't noticed, the lighting is very interesting at this portion of the video. That's because the day before, my husband took out the vanity light that was above the mirror because we did get a new light. I had actually, so you'll see it later, but I'd found a light that I really like for our master bathroom, but it was just too pricey. And so I wanted the smaller version for this bathroom because I really liked it, the shades specifically, like the glass shades. But again, too pricey. And I was happening to look on Wayfair, which is where I had seen the original piece, and they had like a cheaper version. And that sounds mean, but like it just wasn't as fancy, but it had the same shades, same look, and shape. And so I was good with that. And they actually had, so we needed a 3-light vanity light and they had it on sale. So originally it was like $120 and it was on sale for 50% off. So it was like 60. Well, when we got it, we actually didn't open it all the way until we were going to install it and didn't notice, probably this day actually, that there was a discoloration on one of the parts, and you'll see that later. And whenever I was going to return it, it just gave me the option to get a 40% refund. So I ended up paying for a new light for like $20, which was a great deal to me. You can't see the imperfection just from normally standing there, even if you were to look really hard. So that was a good deal to me. But all that to say, we have no light in here. So I had to get creative. I started off with my big light that attaches to my camera. Well, then that died and I had to bring in my husband's office like stand light. It was fun. So if you see a lot of lighting intrigue, that's what that is, but it will be remedied soon. We're starting off with the first coat of the green, and then while that dries, I'm going to do the white color that will go around the lighting. I need to do just a quick edging and coat right there so that as soon as my husband gets home this day, he can install the light. And the paint will be dry by then. So all that, we are into the fun part, but the fun part takes so long. Thank goodness for adjusted speed in videos.
Full stop. Can't believe I live in your thoughts. I think about you all the time, morning, evening, and midnight. Such a wonderful delight. Forgo, give up everything that I own. Yeah, I'd give it all up now just to be with you somehow. Unexpected love was found. You're the rose in a garden. Shows if I'm honest, you're the leaves in mid-August, and I've come out here to say that I love you. Ooh, ooh, you, ooh, ooh. So slow. You in my arms won't let go. The world around could pass us by. A thunderstorm, a lightning strike, as we hold each other tight. You're the rose in a garden, and it shows if I'm
Okay, friends, let's see if I can finally get someone to answer one of my questions in the comments. I have been posing a few questions in some of my videos and I haven't gotten any specific answers. So let's see if we can do it today. I want to know, what is a hobby that you really enjoy doing, but you either don't have the time, don't make the time, or there's another reason why you don't partake in said hobby? For me, I used to really enjoy drawing or painting, and I'm not exceptionally good at it. I'm not even moderately that good at it, but really the main reason why I don't, or I stopped, is perfectionism. I would look at people who actually have that skill and compare my work to theirs and determine that it wasn't worth my time, it wasn't worth the effort, it wasn't going to turn out, you know, superb. But any time that I have sat down and either did a small little project or something intentional, it just brings me a lot of joy. It's just the comparison. Comparison is the thief of joy. And that has done that for me in hobbies. And so I actually have a piece that I want to do soon. In our living room, we have a long blank wall, and we just haven't found anything that fits what we want in that space. And I was reading one day and just an image came to my mind and I thought, I want to do that. And I have bought all the supplies. I have all of the inspiration pictures that I looked up, and I'm going to do it. It just doesn't turn out good enough for our living room. Maybe our downstairs would enjoy that piece of art, but I'm going to do it. I don't want comparison to rob me of joy anymore, especially in something like this. So let me know, what is a hobby you enjoy? What's keeping you from doing it? And as I'm challenging myself, I want to challenge you to bring yourself some joy.
Sometimes we act like a fool, not aware we're troublemakers. Sometimes we try to be cool, not being givers, only takers. watching the stars and the city lights. Right from the start, said we never grow apart, dear Wichita. You wanted me to know, never ever let you go, dear Wichita. Surrounded by colors, it's such a sight. Watching all the lovers fall into the night. All the moods in the heartbeat. We're going back where it all began. The same ground on the high feet. Starts to shake with the wrong weekend. Winter time to spring. On its knees, you know, guidance overseas. I'm telling you, oh, it's more to this than what you see. You know, this town's got the best of me. Are we sure it's the last time? Sure that this is the
I had finished all the painting. I went to bed. I woke up the next day and I came into the bathroom to do all the finishing stuff. And then I realized, oh yeah, I intended to paint the door, which meant that I also needed to paint the trim. So we weren't quite done yet, but I'm so glad that I took that extra time to finish it out right, because I really think that the trim and the door painted, that same green just grounds it and you don't have that eye break from the green board and batten and then the white door. I think that it was the right call. So I'm glad that we did that. And then we just needed to finish up. We had to put the new toilet paper holder on, which was just cleaner and sleeker than the old one we had. And then just a little hook for the towel, which I mentioned before. And we're bringing in all the same decorations that I did for the fall decorate. I did add one more piece of art in here. I had that print downloaded from Etsy and then I printed it. We had it hanging in our hallway, but it just wasn't right in that space. And the green just went really well with this green. So it found its home here, but we're putting everything else back in here. I did end up changing the light bulbs. I had bought energetic daylight light bulbs because I figured they would be cleaner and crisper for the camera, but it was just too much. I felt like I was walking into the hospital. So I did need to go a little bit softer, but after all that, we're going to do a little bit of cleaning and then we'll see the after.
Stars in the city light. And all the moods in the heartbeat. We're going back where it all began. The same ground on the high feet. Starts to shake me through all we can. But we're caught in a landslide. So we stay up to the I know we won't be late.
you so much for being here and for watching. Let me know how you think it turned out in the comments below. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I will see you very soon for another video. Bye, friends.